Good evening and welcome to the IHSAA Boys Class 1A Sectional Number 50. Tonight's matchup is the Argos Dragons versus the Culver Cavaliers. We want to thank everyone to the broadcast. Welcome you all in for tonight's event with two RTC school family on both Culver and Argos. So here we are. We got Phil on the computer. Amy is going to be helping out with the broadcast.
Good evening.
And then Peyton's on the camera. We're going to do what we can to give you as much action tonight as possible. We got lots going on. We just watched Triton go out with a big win over
West Central.
West Central. Both Triton and West Central mascots are the Trojans. So I just said I think they were rival clans.
I think so.
That's about the best way you could pronounce it there. So Triton came out on top, which was predicted. The Dragons have the second matchup of the evening starting at 8 o'clock tonight.
Or
later.
Yep.
Considering
ran a little over on that
everything ran late. We still have 11 minutes on the clock for warm-ups before the starting lineups, the national anthem. I don't think they'll do that again.
They probably did that. No, they already did it.
But yeah, I've seen that. People do it two different ways. We'll just go with the flow. We're going to do those. I got starting lineups. So tonight's matchup, let's take a look at the record so far. Amy, go ahead.
Well, the Dragons are 13-9 coming into this game. Coach Mawson.
450.
Yep,
reached his 450 mark.
Yep. We've actually, Culver coming into this game is 1-20. This will be the third time that Argos has faced them. First time was back on January 24th at the Bi-County. Argos won that game 58-34, and then the bell game that we have with them, February 13th at Argos, we won 66-21. So,
well, the sides, according to scores and previous matchups, it's definitely favorable for the Dragons. But just like anything else, you have to show up to play the game, and anything can happen in postseason.
Any team can beat any other team on any given night.
So, Dragons have an injury with Dylan Kendig with the old broken foot.
Yeah.
Lunchtime mishap.
Tomfoolery. That's my word of the week.
Tomfoolery. Two years.
Mawson wasn't happy about that one.
2 years in a row, Ian Kendig. He got injured last year at lunchtime.
Was that last year?
Yeah.
Yeah, he got a broken nose out
broken
of it.
Broken nose, and Dylan gets a broken foot, so.
He got to wear the Les Mis mask.
Yeah, I told Jackson Kendig that his dad and mom have a no playing at lunchtime laws for him so he doesn't get injured when he gets in high school. So, but it's going to be a good matchup tonight. We got lots going on. It's been it's a beautiful, well, kind of a spring evening.
It is kind of nice outside.
So
we got to come over here. We're over here at the Trojan Trench.
Yeah, the Trojan Trench. They got a nice facility set up for us, and the hospitality room's always very good. We appreciate all that. So Phil and the gang, Phil's in softball mode. His season's getting ready to start for the Lady Dragons softball team.
I have to say, you know, I'm not a big softball watcher, but yeah, that means that spring is coming. So
softball's practice.
Come on, softball.
Coming. Now Steve Stricker, our main man in charge, he spent the beautiful weekend down at Indiana for the state girls championship where one of our
Bankers Life Fieldhouse.
Yeah, team schools, Pioneer, come up just a touch short.
2 points, I think.
2 points, yeah. And end up second, but that was a phenomenal run.
Runner up, great job,
runner
ladies.
Runner up for the state. Congratulations to Pioneer. The Lady Dragons did this 2016, and now the Lady Pioneer. So RTC4's got a lot of good stuff going on with the teams in their family of schools. Pioneer's very strong in football. Obviously, the Dragons did very well in soccer, winning state this year. A lot of good things from a lot of schools, given a lot of great TV action for the home viewers. And we want to thank RTC TV4 for everything they've done and everybody watching Argos TV and anyone watching at Culver TV as far as that goes. So we want to thank everybody. What we're going to do is we're going to take a quick break. We're going to get a couple things around with for some more of the pregame. And then we'll come back with some starting lineups for both squads. And let's see what the tip-off has.
We'll have some commercials, and then they may see some court with no voices. We're here. We'll come back. We swear. We promise.
Okay? We're going to come back. So with that, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back in a few minutes.
Locally owned and operated, Mike's Trash LLC in Rochester is your local service for all your trash removal needs. Whether you're a big business or a local resident, Mike's Trash LLC will be sure to take care of all of your waste removal needs. Contact Mike's Trash LLC today. Call them at 574-223-6429 or stop by the office located at 824 Main Street in beautiful Rochester, Indiana.
There's no better time than now to buy or refinance a home, and there's no better place to go for a mortgage loan than First Federal Savings Bank.
Mortgage rates are still incredibly low, so now would be a great time to come in to talk to one of our loan experts.
We are here to help you find the right type of loan to fit your needs.
We've been proudly serving the mortgage needs of our communities since 1966, and you'll always deal with people you know at locally owned First Federal Savings Bank.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
Let Evans Agency help you with plans covering home, vehicle, life, business, farm, health, and senior insurance. With over 16 years of experience, Evans Agency will be sure to match you with the perfect plan. Visit them at www.evansagencyrochester.com or call today at 574-224-6988 for a free quote.
Nutrien Ag Solutions is the world's largest company for crop inputs, with more than 1,000 global locations. Nutrien Ag Solutions strive to help growers achieve the highest yields with the most sustainable solutions possible. Stop by their local location just east of Fulton or call at 574-857-3555 or visit online at www.nutrienagsolutions.com to see how Nutrien can help you.
Do you have questions about Medicare supplement insurance? Let's sit down and talk. Here at First Federal Savings Bank, you'll meet with a licensed local agent to explore your different options. We can customize a plan that fits your needs and budget. Call me 574-223-1705 for a free consultation.
I'm John Oliver letting you know that our pre-owned inventory has a history with no mystery. Most are one-owner, local trade-ins. We inspect each trade as if our own child was going to be the next owner. We do a 40-point inspection including brakes, tires, and wiper blades. Next, we review and update the scheduled maintenance. At Oliver Ford Lincoln in Plymouth, a pre-owned purchase is a worry-free purchase.
The innocence of youth. Is there anything any better? But soon they'll be in high school and facing all the same challenges you faced. How to make friends. How to fit in. How to be cool. We want our children to have everything they'll need to live fulfilling and productive lives. Make sure the kids in your family are among the more than 160,000 participants here in Indiana who take part in high school sports.
All right, we're back.
Got a little under 4 minutes.
Yep, we got 4 minutes to go. Culver Cavalier just come back out and are continuing to warm up, and the Dragons just went into the locker room to get the final instructions from Coach Mawson. So Coach James Heffley for the Culver Cavaliers looking to get something big response out of the boys here for postseason. Max preps for Triton, and they're going to be playing lacrosse on Friday evening. Triton was 12-10. Lacrosse was 6-15 on the season. The winner of this tonight between the Cavaliers and the Dragons will be facing Oregon Davis. That will be the second game again. So approximate, huh?
on Friday.
Friday night,
I had
night,
to look because I thought you had
o'clock.
It wrong.
No.
I'm sorry.
Approximately at 8 o'clock tonight.
Wives, every now and
Friday
then our husbands
night.
Are right. I swore it was Thursday.
No.
Now, those games are, again, 6:30 and 8.
Because lacrosse
is also in slow time.
Slow time.
Oh, and don't forget this weekend, switch your clocks.
Ha! Wind the clocks, people.
Wind them?
Wind them. No, they don't always wind them. You got to wind it tighter or wind it looser. See how it goes.
Or just turn your clocks back and out.
Yeah,
don't forget to do
that. We're turning it back. So the Dragons are back out. We got the two-minute warning. They're going to shoot around a bit. And then we'll have...
Get our starting lineups.
Starting lineups around.
Getting our school songs going here.
We had the Dragons and then the Cavaliers next, so...
That was the Cavaliers.
Yep. Dragons was right before it.
Oh, I didn't hear ours.
Well...
No, yeah. Okay, ladies, once again, your husband is sometimes wrong.
Sometimes right.
Now we have the Dragon Fight song on Wisconsin.
On Wisconsin, as they say. All right. So Manikowski broke 1,000 points this year, and Owen Nifong has a chance to do the same. Obviously, more games will help, and it would be the first time
Two players
from the same graduating class has done it in a very, very long time. I don't have the stats from back in the 70s when the Odell boys and the Powells and the whole group with Calhoun.
Now, did they have three-pointers?
They didn't even have three-pointers.
That's craziness.
Spirit of 76, the Argos Dragons hold the record for consecutive regular season wins with 76 back in the day. And the average score was 80-some points a game, 80 to 84, I think. And that was pre-three-point line.
Not a lot of running gun.
Pre-three-point line. Just imagine that, folks, getting 80 points a game without three-pointers. Just crazy to think about. So here we go. We
That's
got
awesome.
About 25 seconds left, and I think it was actually Triton that broke the streak.
Yeah.
77. They said there was a big controversy over some very, very controversial calls by the officiating staff because they really wanted it broke.
Oh.
So let's see what we got here. We got the lineups. They should have introduced and announced the non-starters first. I don't know. Sometimes they do that.
They did that at Culver, didn't they, for the girls?
They forgot Argos when they did it.
Oh.
Remember that?
No.
I do. It happens. All right.
Once again, I'd like to welcome everybody tonight to the Trojan Trench for our second game of our sectional, featuring the Culver Cavaliers and the Argos Dragons.
Sectional 50. All right.
On behalf of the IHSAA and the Triton Administration, we welcome you as our guest at tonight's contest. Now, let's meet your players first for the visiting team, the Culver Cavaliers.
Culver Cavaliers are the visitors.
Non-starters are number 15, Braxton Conley. Number 22, Oliver Morgan.
15, Braxton Conley. 22, Oliver Morgan.
Richard DeSilva.
25, Richard DeSilva.
Number 30, Shane Schumann.
Number 33, Josh Havron.
Number 31,
Marquez Anderson. And for your starting Culver Cavaliers, number 3, Owen Valaquette. Number 4, Hunter Mans.
Number 11,
Donovan Giaggia.
Number
20, Jalen King. And number 54, Austin Zahner. Coached by James Havley.
And now, let's meet the Argos Dragons.
The home team, the Argos Dragons. Number 15, Caden Nifong. Number 21, Jake Stoltz. Number 25, Elijah Osborne. Number 31, Caden Brady. Number 32, Teddy Redinger. Number 41, Dylan Kindig. Broken foot, Dylan. Number 43, Colin O'Dell. And number 55, Aiden Mills. And for your starting lineup, number 3, Sam Manikowski. Number 5, J.J. Morris. Number 23, Michael Richard. Number 33, Caleb Ellis. And number 35, Owen Nightfall. Coached by Gordon Lawson. All right.
Back here again. Dragons last year made it to the regional.
Regionals, yep. Took the sectional. Made the regional finals against the
Fort Wayne Blackhawks,
who ended up being the state championship.
Signed to Purdue, is that what I saw?
I think he might have signed to Purdue. He had a bunch
Somebody
of first.
Somebody just signed to Purdue.
He had a bunch of Class 1 offers. I don't know if he's already signed. He's only a junior now, so he has another year yet. He went up from Blackhawk over to Laramie to play for a national title instead of just states.
Yeah. Hey, if anybody's out there watching and you want a shout-out, and you got Andy's or my cell phone numbers.
Text us. Coach Phil Dean a text.
Yeah.
You can send Steve Stricker a text and he'll get with us.
Yeah.
Here we go.
We love to give shout outs.
Morris wins the tip. And Manikowski across the timeline. Richard. Morris gets it. To Nightfall. Manikowski looks. Loves that from the corner and just misses. Rebound goes to Culver.
One of his world famous.
Yes. Mans with the rebound. Comes across the line. Man-to-man defense for the Dragons. Zija had it. Kicks it over to Mans. Richards on him. Good pressure from the Dragons. It's loose, and Ellis gets it, and Manikowski comes away. Richard has it. Nifong. Man-to-man by the Cavaliers. Gives it over to Manikowski. Richard. Tends to make his very first three-pointer of the evening. What a layup from Richard. Takes it in, and he's got two for the night.
Caleb Ellis.
Nope.
Michael Richard. Oh.
Correction. Michael Richard.
23-33.
It's okay. He's out on him.
With the girls, it's usually their ponytails that are
in
the way.
Nifong's on him. Mans gets it. Zija gets it. Has it over there. Nifong. And Valaquette gets it back. King has it out with Ellis on him. They switch, still man-to-man. Valaquette, double-teamed. Dragons kind of have Culver stale late at the moment. Culver's looking out high. Ball's loose.
Might be a long game.
Well.
Oh.
Valaquette gets it over. Dragons just have to remain composed, thinking about this. And then Culver has got to keep control of it. Ball's loose. I just talked about it, and Manikowski gets it. And Culver comes away with it, even though Manikowski saved it from going out of bounds after he tipped it away. Step out on him. There you go. Just put that hand out so the official tie. Elbows hits Manikowski in the jaw. First foul of the evening. And all Valaklet did was just kind of come across with his arm with the ball, but his elbow caught Manikowski right in the jaw. So there was a few minutes off the clock. Back door, Manikowski. Blocked. Zahner gets the ball away. Good rebound from Zahner. Block shot by the Cavs. Valaquette goes. Loose.
First foul by the Dragons.
First foul on Mike Richard. He got the bucket and he's got the foul.
He is padding his stats tonight. He's gone.
Well, that's. There's been zero attempts by the Cavaliers. And when I mean attempts, zero shots. Gets it in, barely. Valaquette. Trap looks, gets it, tries to get over. Valaquette gets it in the corner to King. Back out to him. Culver's definitely has the game plan to keep it tight.
Well, if Argos can't get the ball, we can't score. I totally get that.
Right now they're up by two, which is twice as many points as Culver. Valaquette.
And on that one, Mikey Richard will be coming out. Maybe. Maybe not.
So Culver Cavaliers is just trying to get the Dragons maybe in foul trouble. Somebody or something. I don't know. This is a very peculiar plan.
Oh, he just made. Oh. Yep, I kind of wondered if he wasn't aware that that was. Looks like Ted Redinger will be going in for. Oh, the 5 second call. Call
five
against
seconds.
Ted,
so
Teddy Redinger will be coming in for Mike Richard.
He has two fouls. So the Dragons have gone down, had a block shot, missed a shot, and scored a shot. Culver's gone down, had an offensive foul, and a turnover, and a turnover. This foul. Zero attempts. I don't know.
Foul on Valaquette. That was his second, isn't it? Yeah.
Two on Valaquette. Two on Richard.
Well, at least we're consistent on something here.
Well, they're the only ones fouling, so yeah.
Yeah.
Manikowski breaks in the bucket. Great feed from Nifong. Dragons up by four. Mikey Richard ties it up, and it's going to be Culver's ball.
It's Teddy Redinger.
Teddy Redinger. But it will be Culver's ball again.
Just got to keep you square here.
I can hardly keep up with all the fast-paced action.
You're doing
King
a great
catches
job.
It. Mans. Valaquette with two fouls. Gonna have to be careful. King drives, shots up, and he gets the bucket off of an unorthodox shot.
Looks like Caleb Ellis came away with that foul.
Yep. So Culver is all four guys are back, not even
they
trying
did
for a rebound.
This the last time we played them.
misses the free throw.
They stop any fast break attempts, though.
Ellis gets it. Ellis fakes, kicks it out. Nifong, Redinger for three, and misses. Rebound goes to Manikowski. Fakes, kicks it over to Morris. Morris misses, and Dragons can't get to it.
About a minute and a half left in this first half, quarter.
Timeout by Culver. And it looks like it's going to be 30-second timeout. We'll be back right after this.
First Federal Savings Bank can help you remodel your home, consolidate debt, or even provide a little spending cash with our home equity line of credit.
Our standard home equity line of credit allows you to draw funds for up to 10 years and comes with no closing costs for qualified customers.
Take advantage of this great opportunity. Contact one of our local experienced lenders or apply online at firstfederalbanking.com.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
Hey, we're back.
We are. Minute 27 left in the first. Dragons up 4-2. To say it's been a peculiar first half.
First quarter
is an understatement. Looks to get it in, and he does. Mans. Zijic gets it. Looks, got Nifong on him. Balaquette. Stolen. Gets it up to Nifong. Can he get there in time? And he does. And gets it over to Redinger. Manikowski fakes. Shot. No good. Tips it out. Nifong gets a foul. Drawn. King is the committer. Yep, gives it to King, his first.
We're tied in fouls, 3-3.
Well, Manikowski. In and out, puts it in for two.
In and out, and then in again.
Yes, it did.
Yeah.
Hit all four corners of the rim like a hit. So.
6-2.
And he's by himself, and J.J. Morris loses his mark.
King has
four.
Culver has four. Good job.
9 seconds left. Dragons going to get the last second shot.
Definitely.
Nifong. And 6-4 at the end of the first. That's going to do it. We'll be back right after this.
At First Federal Savings Bank, we offer a wide selection of valuable services for our customers.
We offer a variety of deposit products, such as personal and business accounts.
We pride ourselves in being one of the top mortgage lenders in Indiana.
At First Federal Savings Bank, we offer business loans and business checking accounts. Give us a call at any one of our branch locations and let us help you.
Through LPL Financial, our financial services department is here to help you with your financial planning needs.
Come see us today and see how our family can help your family.
The Winning Edge is your local provider for all your school athletic needs. From providing customizable sportswear to engraving trophies, The Winning Edge strives to help teams find their edge on the playing field. Visit The Winning Edge today.
Locally owned and operated, Mike's Trash LLC in Rochester is your local service for all your trash removal needs. Whether you're a big business or a local resident, Mike's Trash LLC will be sure to take care of all your waste removal needs. Contact Mike's Trash LLC today.
And we're back into the first quarter. Dragons up 6-4.
Barn burner.
Culver's had two attempts on shots, and they've both gone in. But two attempts in the one quarter is not a very good stat. Dragons have shot about six times, but have made three, so. But they're still in.
Warmed up for the second quarter.
I don't know if Coach Mawson's just going to have them run and gun and take it to them to try to break that monotony of the offensive end.
We'll see.
Manikowski has it. And Nifong. King steals it. Tipped. Mans. Zaisha over to Valquette. Double teamed.
Looks like Colin Odell came in for.
Yep, he did for J.J.
Morris. Morris. Sorry, the name left me for a second. I apologize. I don't know Culver's players well enough. I don't think they subbed anybody.
Mans, no.
Okay.
Zaisha kicks it over. Zahner. Zaisha over to Valaquette. Up top of the key. Mans has it out wide. Picks up his dribble. Zahner comes and gets it.
Broken ankles down there or what?
Well, actually, the Argos player tripped the Argos player. It wasn't anything that they did. Our teammates are breaking ankles. Trapped. King. Two-handed shove by Sanja.
What was that for? I saw.
Yeah, he just kind of pushed the knife on out of the way.
Why? He just asked why. Well, because he had a two-handed shove. He. Yeah. We'll have to watch. He's saying there was some contact.
He said there was a grab, but there was no grab. It was just a kind of a shove, frustration.
Two-handed shove will always get you.
Retaliate, and you'll be the one in trouble.
Could be Argus ball. Oh, I thought he touched it. Oh, we touched it second. Okay.
Yes.
All right.
And
looks like Jake Stoltz is going to be going in for the Dragons.
Nifong's taking a break.
Yep. Getting us ahead of the game here.
Well, the Culver game plan is working as far as limiting
the shots.
They're keeping
us from shooting.
But there's another steal for the Dragons. And then
Boston's just shaking his head. Okay, that's a Dragon turnover. It'll be Culver ball.
They stole it. And then a turnover. The Dragons are kind of looking like the Bad News Bears at the moment, unfortunately. Even though that they're still up.
I love that movie.
And they've only allowed two shots all game. Nifong's going back in. Gets it to King.
Six.
Misses.
Oh, no.
And Stoltz can't hold on to the rebound.
We need some of that glue stuff.
And Zaisha ties it up. And Coach Marshall calls a timeout. We'll be back after this.
Let RTC TV4 highlight your business or service in our local sports coverage. Through our platform, you have the option to use a 30-second commercial that you already have, or you can have us make a 15-second logo sponsorship for you. With 8 local schools in our partnership, we're sure you'll reach your intended audience. Sponsor with RTC TV4 today.
All right, we're back. Zaisha with two. High ball game. Six. to six. All right. The starting five is in, with the exception of Mike Richard. He's been replaced by Redinger because Richard has two fouls. Nifong said King tipped it out, but the official said no. Another turnover by the Dragons. Looks for a trap on Mans. Gets it over to Vrijza. Mans has it. Sijah has it. Caddy over to Mans. Over to Valaquette. Mans.
I almost think they need to anticipate those passes. But
well, it's kind of obvious what Culver's doing, and Dragons are just going to have to deal with
and
a holding offense.
The double teaming.
Stolen. Ball's loose. Steps on the line. Dragons basketball.
Dragons really need to capitalize on this turnover. Or steal. Whatever
something
you want to call it.
It was a turnover.
Put some points on the board.
Yep. Manikowski gets it to Redinger. Nifong. Ellis. Morris, up and one. Good for Morris, the freshman.
Dragons held scoreless until that point.
Oh, wow.
This whole quarter. First foul on number 54, Zahner.
Puts it in. Morris with three. Nine to six.
I suppose we can't hope for a 2-hour delay tomorrow.
No luck, folks.
Earn it.
Mans has it out high. Runs off, kicks in the middle to King. King surrounded, out to Valaquette. Ball's loose again, Redinger has it. Redinger gets him in the air and misses.
And passes to...
Steps on the line. Use the glass, boys, use the glass. Had him in the air with
they
the ball fake.
That cute little triangle or
square.
Triangle. Square in the back.
Yeah.
Like a
stole it again and then convert. Mans drives, kicks it over to Zahner. Back over to Mans.
A little under 2 minutes left in this first quarter.
First half.
Second quarter, sorry.
Well, you lose track of time. With this one, hands it over.
You're watching first round sectional action on RTC TV4, Argos TV on Argos TV. I can't even say it.
Argos TV on RTC TV 4.
Thank you.
And there's a foul on Redinger.
He is first. Team 4. Looks like Jake Stoltz will come back into the game.
Give Redinger a quick break.
Substitution for the Dragons, number 41, Jake Stoltz.
Mance tries to go all the way through. Balaquet. Zayner recovers the tip away. And Nifong with the foul.
Unlucky.
Argos foul, number 35, Nifong.
Stolen.
Sam had his.
Stoltz puts it in for two. Good feed by Morris. Dragons steal it and convert with the fast break. It's been a slow half.
Oh my God.
Zayner gets it, puts it over to Zaija. Manikowski just about steals it. Jump ball, Culver's basketball. It's a odd game plan to hold it as much as they are. And yeah, you've held the Dragons to 11, but you also almost doubled your score. Out of bounds, and it's gonna be Culver's basketball.
We're able to keep the from scoring.
Yeah.
A little over 30 seconds left in this half.
Yep.
Quarter, half.
Stolen by Stoltz. Gets it to Manikowski. Dragons are going to come away with a, going to hold it for the last second shot.
Sam getting a little instruction from the coach.
Nine seconds. Gets it to Morris. Morris looks at the clock and Jay hooks it in. Morris with five. And Dragons go in 13-6 at the end of the first half. We'll take a break. It won't take long to do stats on this one. We'll be back right after this.
At Co-Alliance, we understand the importance of community. After all, we've been farmer-owned since the 1920s. And now that we're a part of your community, we want to become your total agronomy solutions provider. Co-Alliance offers the latest in ag technology for your operation. From field scouting and fertilizers to premium seed and precision agriculture, we can help take your operation to the next level. Put the resources of your local cooperative to work. Contact Co-Alliance today.
I remember what it was like to buy my first home. I was nervous, but with the help of First Federal Savings Bank mortgage experts, you have no need to worry.
At First Federal Savings Bank, we enjoy working with first-time homebuyers. And with our premier first-time homebuyer loan program, there is no PMI and as little as 5% down payment is required for this program.
Talk with one of our experienced mortgage lenders and let us help you purchase your first home.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
Argos Hardware is your local do-it-best hardware store, offering everything you need for your home improvement, lawn and garden, housewares, and home decor. Argos Hardware prides itself on a knowledgeable and friendly staff. Stop by today to stock up on all of your winter preparation needs, like shovels or ice melt. Argos Hardware is located at 200 West Walnut Street in Argos. Argos Hardware, your local do-it-best hardware store.
Hi, I'm John Oliver. We love our customers and we work hard to prove it every day. Buy a car? Get free car washes for the life of that car. When your car needs service, we provide a new loaner at no charge. Plus, we give you a complimentary alignment check each time we service your car. That increases tire life. And when you do need tires, we sell them at the lowest price guaranteed. Feel the love at Oliver Ford Lincoln in Plymouth.
What rhymes with great?
Participate.
Where does greatness start? Here, in the classroom.
On the diamond.
In the pool.
On the field.
Where will your greatness take you?
To better grades.
To more friends.
Yeah!
Be great.
Participate! Yeah.
Got that new home addition and you're keeping it covered.
Ooh, coverages now. I can help with this. Got zone coverage, man coverage, combo coverages.
I don't know, Peyton. I think more like the coverage your Nationwide agent offers.
Oh, you want to go there. Home, auto, life, business, farm, boat, RV, ATV, camper, pet, motorcycle, your tour bus. Right. Did I mention farm?
Contact Jennings Insurance Agency today or visit one of our offices in Argos and Rochester. Enjoy full-screen television viewing of the new RTC TV4 family of networks anywhere you are with our new Roku channel. Simply purchase a Roku device from RTC or any Roku retailer, connect to your in-home Wi-Fi, then download the RTC TV4 channel. It's that easy. Watch all of our live channels 24/7 for free. Or subscribe to view all of our videos at your convenience. The RTC TV4 channel on Roku, another great service from RTC.
All right, we're back. Here we go. Minute left till tip, second half. So four scores for Culver. Zijia with two. King with four. For the Dragons, Richard with two. Stoltz with two. Manikowski with four. Morris with five. 13-6. No, folks, this isn't the end of the first quarter. It's not halfway through the first quarter. This is the start of the second half. 13-6. Culver's got a game plan where they are holding the ball, limiting possessions, limiting shots for...
That's limiting points.
For both teams.
Yeah.
They've made four attempts for the first half. Yep, made three of them, which is very good percentage. But in turn, you only score 6 points and a half. It's going to be hard to come out with a lead. That's what Coach was worked on. That's what he's trying to do. So now we're going to see if he catches the Dragons off guard with going out immediately.
With
and
a different plan, maybe.
With a different plan of going quick and trying to get it so they can get a quick bucket. We'll see what happens. See Coach
Second
Mawson.
Second half action.
Yeah, Coach Mawson probably let the boys have action. A little bit for turnovers and some control.
But catching the ball.
Other than that,
ball on
you know,
their fingers.
Richard back in with two fouls. It was probably the lowest amount of fouls I've seen.
Balaclet also had two fouls, yes. I think, and then maybe.
I think there was only about five per team.
Yeah,
first
it
half.
Wasn't. I don't think there was anyone else that was in foul trouble.
Nope. Manikowski gets it. Down over to Morris. Morris baseline looks, fakes, gives it over to Nifong.
Should be Dragon's ball.
Yep.
Somebody just say slow it down.
Yes. And Val, big Val, Rochester Sentinels here. Manikowski. Richard. And Valaklet got to be careful. He's got his hands on Manikasi. He'll catch a quick third early on in the half, and he may have to sit. Morris for two and sinks it. And another and one opportunity. J.J. Morris with seven on the night.
That foul is on Zahner. His second, I believe, yep.
These Cavaliers have not taken a break yet. Starting five's been in. And Morris puts it in. Morris with eight. The freshman towing the line for the Dragons, who's up by 10 now. Manns. Greeted by Richard across the timeline. And Valaquette dribbles out of it. King fakes. And
should be Dragon Ball.
Dragons basketball.
Hey, I'm two for two.
Turnover by Culver. So they're telling the players, watch out for it. Manikowski for three, and he's off. And Ellis comes around for the jump ball, and it's going to be Culver's basketball again. Manikowski with four on the evening. Low numbers for him. Nifong with zero, and that's low numbers for him. He's going to want to get in this mix. Valaquette and Manns have not scored for the Cavaliers. 5 seconds, and Dragons get another turnover off of the Cavaliers. Mikey Richard fakes, gets the ball over to Morris. To Ellis. Nifong, got hands on him, kicks it over to Morris, loses it.
Sticky fingers. Gonna get some of that little sticky stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Tacky.
Zahner, Zijah, and back. Valaquette. King fakes, drives, loses it.
Should be Culver ball.
Yep. Culver, inbound play. Zijah looks. Gets it. Tipped. Out of bounds. It's going to be Culver's. Gets it in quick that time. Valaquette. Manns. Drives and blocked by Morris. Kicks it over to Richard. Manikowski has it. I think you'll see Dragons go into a fast break routine as soon as they can. Morris. Richard. Manikowski. Nifong comes over with it. Rotates it out. Manns is on Richard. Manikowski. Manikowski misses. And Nifong comes over with it. Morris drives, shots up, misses. Rebound, King.
A lot of body on that one.
Yep. Aliquette gets it. Zayner comes to the rescue, gets it over. Zaisha. Bench warning on the coach, Farm Culver.
Not sure what. Manikowski tried to knock it down court, but got a foot on the line.
Mams comes across the timeline. King over to Zaija. Looks, breaks away. Zayner again. Zayner has sure hands for the Cavaliers. They get it to him, and he does not let go. King.
Checking the ball for air.
Yep. Kicks it out. King for a long three. No good. Zayner with the rebound.
I'm saying go up with it.
King with the easy layup, and he gets it in. Jordan King. Dragons up 16-8.
Nice grab there by Ellis.
Yep. Nifong. And they give a charge on Nifong. Nifong's first bucket's taken away by a charge and call. His second foul of the evening.
Substitution for the Dragons, number 32.
Stokes. Oh, Teddy Redinger, sorry, comes in for J.J. Morris.
Redinger, excuse me.
Did he say Stokes too?
I'm not sure. King has it. And Ellis takes it.
It's not travel because there's two hands on the ball.
Argus basketball. Ellis took it right away from King, and they smothered him afterwards on the ground. Manikowski to Richard. Fakes, drives, loses it. Off of Culver, Dragons ball. It's like watching on defense, it's kind of like watching soccer where they put everybody in the 18. They're putting everybody dead center down low.
Yes.
Manikowski puts it in for two. Good feed again by Nifong. Dragons back up by 10, 18-8. This will definitely help the Dragons' defensive average as a team. And Culver calls a timeout with a minute 15 left in the third. We'll be back right after this.
Locally owned and operated, Mike's Trash LLC in Rochester is your local service for all your trash removal needs. Whether you're a big business or a local resident, Mike's Trash LLC will be sure to take care of all of your waste removal needs. Contact Mike's Trash LLC today. Call them at 574-223-6429 or stop by the office located at 824 Main Street in beautiful Rochester, Indiana.
There's no better time than now to buy or refinance a home, and there's no better place to go for a mortgage loan than First Federal Savings Bank.
Mortgage rates are still incredibly low, so now would be a great time to come in to talk to one of our loan experts.
We are here to help you find the right type of loan to fit your needs.
We've been proudly serving the mortgage needs of our communities since 1966.
and you'll always deal with people you know at locally owned First Federal Savings Bank.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
Dragons basketball. Nope, let me see. Culver's basketball, sorry. 18-8. Culver's basketball. Minute 15 left in the third.
We're going to switch sides.
Yep. The officials were inbounding on the wrong side after the timeout, so they wanted to change it. King has it. Goes into a group of dragons. I mean, it was there.
Is that a gaggle?
It was a gaggle.
What a group of dragons.
Mans is out there. He's going to hold it for as long as he can to get a last second shot here at the end of the third. And the fans behind us, the Dragons, are cheering because they're the stellar defense. All right.
Big shout out to
Joel Harmon.
Joel Harmon and Angel Mosley. Watching from home.
They're not Mr. and Mrs. Harmon yet. We'll just stir the pot. 26 seconds left in the third, 18-8. And they're just standing there, and the Dragons have no issues with that. They're up by 10. And they're just going to stack. And they say, come on out, Owen. Mans has it. 8 seconds. Jumper, short, rebound, Nifong. And Nifong's not wasting any time. And misses from the half court. So that'll do it for the end of the third. Dragons are up 18-8. We'll be back right after this.
Are you in need of a great insurance plan? Let Evans Agency help you with plans covering home, vehicle, life, business, farm, health, and senior insurance. With over 16 years of experience, Evans Agency will be sure to match you with the perfect plan. Visit them at www.evansagencyrochester.com or call today at 574-224-6988 for a free quote.
Nutrien Ag Solutions is the world's largest company for crop inputs with more than 1,000 global locations. Nutrien Ag Solutions strive to help growers achieve the highest yields with the most sustainable solutions possible. Stop by their local location just east of Fulton or call at 574-857-3555 or visit online at www.nutrienagsolutions.com to see how Nutrien can help you.
And we're back, start of the fourth quarter. It's going to be Culver Cavaliers basketball. And it's 18-8. It's
Culver ball.
A peculiar one. Culver gets it into King. And he dribbles, jumps in the air, and lands. The Dragons are off a little bit. And the Culver Cavaliers are holding the ball as much as possible. So, gets us a not the most exciting game, but it's definitely a game that's favored by the Dragons. Manikowski drives. Waits till they're in the air and puts it in for two more. Manikowski with eight on the evening. And tipped out of bounds by Nifong. Culver basketball. 20-8. And
tied
his shoes. Just one of them. He's doing okay. King.
King's only a sophomore.
Yep. Mans, Valaquette, Zijia. and Da Silva will all be graduating. Culver has not made a sub the entire night. Mans with the shot, and it's good.
Is that the
his first jumper? His first jumper.
Was that the first jumper? I think the rest layups, I believe.
I think they were layups or attempted layups. That's only the eighth attempt on the evening. So they got a high shooting percentage.
Good hands there by King.
Yep, stolen. One foul per team. And the Culver comes down and scores two in a row. Zahner with two. They've shot two in a row and made them both. Maybe they should have been doing that the entire time.
Maybe we're off and they're on it. Yep. You never know. Well, I'm surprised they didn't call that.
And J.J. Morris is going in, most likely for Richard.
Sometimes when emotions get a little high, you got to.
Ellis has it. Second timeout by the Dragons. We'll be back right after this.
Do you have questions about Medicare supplement insurance? Let's sit down and talk. Here at First Federal Savings Bank, you'll meet with a licensed local agent to explore your different options. We can customize a plan that fits your needs and budget. Call me 574-223-1705 for a free consultation.
And we're back. .42 left in the game. Dragons up 20-12. Well, I hope she had better taste than that. All right, here's Manikowski.
Angel, don't listen to him. He's crazy.
Drives. Kicks it out. Ellis. And I think the Dragons are just going to give the Cavaliers a taste of their own medicine. Foul on King.
We're not near the bonus there. I thought maybe Owen was looking up to see if we were.
No, it's
bonus.
Only the second foul of the half for the Cavaliers. The Dragons have one foul.
I'm getting a little slap happy.
Yep. Manikowski. And one.
Oh, and Knife On puts in his first 2 points of the game.
Got a shove from behind. I think it's going to be on.
King? No.
Nope, they're going to give it to Mans.
Mans, okay.
Yep. And that's Knife On's first bucket of the evening. Looks to make it and one. And short. Mans kicks it over to King, fakes, rotates it out to Valaquette. Mans for three, and he puts it in.
I think you're right. I think maybe
I told you they're trying to do it. They should have been shooting all night. They're trying to lull the Dragons asleep in the first three quarters and then shoot it.
I think we just need to play.
Yeah, Manikowski fakes and lays it in for two more. No foul on Valaquette afterwards. and Manikowski has 10.
Well,
Dragons up by 9. Zahner kicks it out to Zijah. Over to King. Misses. Rebound. Gets it to Redinger, and now Manikowski has it. Valaquette's on him. Kicks it over to Nifong.
3 minutes, 30 seconds left in the fourth.
Not two-handed.
A little bit there.
Yep. Manikowski has it. Manikowski, in for two, out for two.
Here comes Zijah. Four corners.
Kicks it over to Manns. Manns is going to go. Timeout by Culver. We'll be back right after this.
Hi, I'm John Oliver, letting you know that our pre-owned inventory has a history with no mystery. Most are one-owner, local trade-ins. We inspect each trade as if our own child was going to be the next owner. We do a 40-point inspection, including brakes, tires, and wiper blades. Next, we review and update the scheduled maintenance. At Oliver Ford Lincoln in Plymouth, a pre-owned purchase is a worry-free purchase.
First Federal Savings Bank can help you remodel your home, consolidate debt, or even provide a little spending cash with our home equity line of credit.
Our standard home equity line of credit allows you to draw funds for up to 10 years and comes with no closing costs for qualified customers.
Take advantage of this great opportunity. Contact one of our local experienced lenders or apply online at firstfederalbanking.com.
And remember, we don't want to be the biggest bank, just the best bank.
And we're back. Dragons up 24-15. It's Culver's basketball. Gonna give our routine shout out to Abby Manikowski. Hopefully she is not asleep.
Abby, do your homework.
Hopefully she's not asleep watching all this raw excitement, this back and forth action. So here we go.
Big old thank you to people who are texting us, keeping us, I don't want to say awake, but.
Well, it just was a slow game, and now Culver's been shooting lights out from the third and fourth quarter. They could have been doing that the entire time and really, I think they were trying to draw them in and then do it in the fourth and see if they can get something going here.
Another three.
And puts it in again.
Man's second three-pointers, two for two from the three-point line. Got 8 points on the night.
Nifong. Stoltz for three. No good. Rebound. Goes to Culver.
A little slip on the floor there.
Yep. Richards going back in. Zahner.
Zahner will not shoot. I don't.
Well, he made the one. He shot. He only used one for one. Manns has it over to Valaquette. Timeout goes to Culver again. We'll be back. Minute 56 left in the game. Dragons up by 6.
The innocence of youth. Is there anything any better? But soon they'll be in high school and facing all the same challenges you faced. How to make friends. How to fit in. How to be cool. We want our children to have everything they'll need to live fulfilling and productive lives. Make sure the kids in your family are among the more than 160,000 participants here in Indiana who take part in high school sports.
And we're back. I think Mawson has used one timeout the entire game. Culver, I think this was their second or third of this half, third of their half, this half. So
Minute 56 left.
6-point game, Culver basketball.
Culver's got the ball on their end.
The Dragons' strategy to play. Culver's strategy was keep it as close as possible and try to make a run at towards the end of the game, and it's not been too bad. Foul, Manikowski long before the shot. It's his first or second of the evening.
And as we only have one foul, we are safe.
No one's shooting free throws anytime soon since there's.
Oh, you just jinxed it.
There's
Do you know how many fouls they can call it?
There's five fouls between
I don't care.
Both teams.
You don't talk about jump balls either.
And tipped. And Morris is going to have a breakaway if he's fouled from behind hard, and that's Valaquette's third.
Yep, on the shot. Shooting two.
The first sentence of Morris puts it in. Morris. One more and he'll have double digits.
Tell him that it cost him.
25-18, Morris at the line, minute 43 left in the game.
I gotta tell you, I can't believe we're at the end of basketball season.
Misses. Zahner gets the rebound, passes it off. King gonna drive, cut off by Ellis. Gets it over. Zijah. Zahner shoots again and misses.
Oh, he hit that fourth corner. Good shot.
Hollis. Valaquette should have had his fourth and he didn't call it, but King got his. Third. Culver's running out of time. Valaquette with his fourth.
He may not want to do that again. He wouldn't be the one. He's got guys on the bench. I'd be sticking one of them in to foul if that's her.
Yeah, I don't know.
You just said, see, you jinxed it. No one, you said, no one's going to shoot.
That's all right. Nifong has it.
King
and King now has four. No. Oh, yeah, he's got four.
King foul, number seven.
And we're now going to the line for 1-1.
I just jinxed Culver by saying that, I guess.
I told you don't talk about it.
Well, they were doing fouling on purpose. I don't get it. But
that still counts.
Yeah. Nifong puts
Sinks
it in.
That one.
Dragons up 26-18. And puts it in. Mans gets it. 1 minute left. First round action between the Argus Dragons and Culver Cavaliers, sectional 50. Zijah pulls back. Quick shot. Valaquette misses. Rebound, Nifong. And just about broke away, and the foul happened.
Everyone's like, darn it. I think that's one of his favorite things to do.
So, 50 seconds left. Dragons up 27-18. We're cut out. You got him.
Okay.
Nifong puts it in, his fifth on the evening. Dragons up by 10 again. 11. Nifong 4-4 there. The last two trips down at the free throw line. Zahner, Mans. Shots up. No good. Rebound goes to Nifong. Kicks it over to Richard. Over to Morris. Back over to Manikowski. And Manikowski is going to the line.
Zahner gets him.
Got Colin Odell coming in.
Morris taking a break.
So as it stands now, Dragons will be playing Oregon Davis 8 o'clock Friday night.
And Manikowski makes it. He's got 11.
Ellis comes out. Redinger comes in.
Stultz.
Stultz is coming in. Go for the shooter.
Shooter.
Number 43. Colin Odell.
Manikowski misses. Here comes Zijan.
Big three-pointer.
Missed. Manikowski rebounds. Culver.
He's waiting for one of them to just steal it and just go.
And that's going to do it. That's the ball game. 30-18. Culver content with the loss, but not the blowout this time. And that's what they worked at. Very good game plan. Good work for both teams. Definitely a closer game on score. So here we go. We got the stats here for us.
What do you got here? Hold on. I'm checking something.
All right. For the Culver Cavaliers.
Cavaliers, we've got Zaner with two, Zijah with two, King with six, and leading scorer for the Cavaliers was Manns with eight.
For the Dragons, we have Stultz with two, Richard with two, Nifong with six, Morris with nine, and leading all scorers, Sam Manikowski, 11.
Of course, those are official, unofficial stats.
Official, unofficial. So the Dragons are going to advance to the second round to face Oregon Davis Friday night at 10 or 8 a p.m. p.m. in sectional 50. We're going to go ahead and wrap it up for this evening. It was a good game. The Dragons come out and win. So we'll see you on Friday against the Bobcats of Oregon Davis.
You've been watching Argos TV on RTC TV4.
All right. So
for Phil and Peyton and me and
Andy.
Andy here.
All right. We want to thank everyone for the broadcasting. Tuning in. Shout out to all my friends and family watching back home. See you later, Stevie Stricker. Good night. God bless.